Welcome to the second week of 2024 and to our aging puzzle. I am your host, Carlette DeVoe. Our show is truly about aging. But the thing about aging is it affects each and every one of us. It doesn't matter what age we are. We are going to talk about various topics and we're going to bring guests to talk about their experiences one-on-one. We want to find out how life is affecting them, because I'm sure that they are not the only ones going through their struggles, their challenges, and their experiences. So we want to have one-on-one conversations with our guests so they can share their journey with you. And I'm sure there'll be someone out there that can relate. Our guests are going to be from all walks of life and from ages young, middle-aged, or seniors. Now, I'll tell you something. As we journey together through this year, we anticipate that the chance of hearing a story that will evoke some kind of emotion is high. You're either going to laugh, or you're going to cry, or somewhere in between. But our stories are meant to inspire us and provide valuable insights in current topics, health concerns, and ways to lead a healthier, longer life. So get ready for an inspiring time of listening, learning, connecting with each other, and having fun. In our continued exploration of this month's topic, understanding and coping with child abandonment by a mother, we have our guest this month, Terry Howell. She is brave, and she is sharing her personal experience. Very heart-wrenching, heartbreaking, and personal. She's going to share conversations about her vulnerability, what she has gone through. She wants to help someone understand and heal like she's doing. Not only has Terry gone through this, but Terry is an amazing woman who has graced the screen and the stage. She has her latest movie premiere that really inspired the poignant stories of other women who are navigating through their trials of childhood trauma, just like Terry. Terry's premiere and her show is a raw and unfiltered exploration of human experience. It's a testament to Terry's commitment to using the arts as a means of healing and understanding. Now remember, every month on the show, we have one guest, and this month, Terry is our guest. So we'll have that guest every month to walk us through their story. Remember the first week with Terry, she talked about abandonment by her mother and how she felt. Week two, she's going to talk about manifestations and actions resulting from fear. Then week three, which is next week, we will discuss how did she get help? What does she do? Where does she go to get help? And week four, we're going to hear from Terry. What is she doing about it? And why? So join us every week to hear our guests tell their story, because we're going to take you through a journey. One guest building on their story week after week. Now is time for our aging facts. In January, I just found out that it is designated Glaucoma Awareness Month. The American Academy of Ophthalmology sounds a crucial alarm. They said that the best defense against stealthy onset of glaucoma-related blindness lies in one simple thing. Easy peasy. Routine, comprehensive eye exams. Go every year, get your eye exams, people. These examinations conducted by your eye care professionals can identify signs of glaucoma early, just like everything else. So you want to go early. If you want to save your eyesight, have your eyes checked every year. For those who want more information about glaucoma, you can go to the American Academy of Ophthalmology, because they provide all types of information to give you valuable insights and guidance. And I want to remind everyone, go to your local eye care professional, community health organizations, or anywhere so you can stay informed about preventive measures and treatment options for glaucoma. And again, go and get your eye exam. Every year, every time. We want to prioritize our vision, and we want to prioritize the vision of our eyes. by everyone. We want our loved ones to go check out your vision every year. It's important. Your vision is counting on you. When was the last time you had an eye exam? Let's make an appointment to go get your eyes checked, okay? We're all going. Let's make that a 2024 January goal. Get our eyes checked. Yay! Alrighty, so now it's time to welcome our very special guest, Terry Howell. Terry is a proud native of Detroit. She emerges not only as a versatile professional in dance and choreography and modeling, playwriting, filmmaking, directing, acting, and producing, but this talented young lady is also a compassionate life coach and a spiritual counselor. Wow. She is amazing. So with over 15 years experience in the performing arts and representing BL Productions, Terry is an amazing young woman. She influences people beyond the stage and the screens. She's also a child advocate and an entrepreneur who is devoted to empowering youth and uplifting those who have triumphed over life's adversity, just like she has. Terry's films go beyond entertainment, such as a powerful instrument to illuminate voices that demand attention. That is what she is doing. She wants you to hear the story so it can make a difference. And she does that through film. What an amazing, inspiring young lady. Please welcome to the show, Terry Howell. Welcome back to our aging puzzle. Wow. Remember last week, we began our exploration into the profound impact of maternal abandonment. Such a sad and painful topic for this month. And we have with us our guest again for the second week in a row, and she'll be with us all month long. Terry is talking about abandonment by her mother, her personal experience and her personal journey. Thank you so much for being with us again, Terry.
Thank you for having me again.
Fantastic. So today we're going to delve into the aftermath, how the intense emotions manifested in actions, particularly in fear. Terry, could you share with us your personal journey, shedding the light on the complexity of navigating life after such a traumatic experience like being left behind and abandoned by your mother? Talk to us about how you navigated life at 12 years old.
Well, I had a nervous condition. I started biting my nails. It was hard for me to sleep at night. I didn't really eat a lot because my stomach was always nervous. So if I did eat, I threw it up. My nervous system was completely shot. The only thing that I did have that really allowed me to, I would say, like an outlet. I was a professional dancer. My mother put me in dance school, and I think it saved my life during this time. When I was 5 years old, all the way through college. And during those times, that was my way of escape. The music and the songs that we had were like telling the story. So it was my way to break away from my reality and actually stay in my creative mindset. But outside of that, I was very fearful, nervous. If I had a favorite teacher and we got really close, I was scared she was gonna leave. I was the fear of everything was that anything I wanted, it was going to leave. I was either going to break it, something was going to happen. And so I always had a pre-notion of these things are not good enough for me and something is going to happen and I'm going to lose it because I marked it as this. I measured that time of my mother leaving, with everything else, it was going to be that way.
Right.
So mentally, that was not a healthy space to even function in. Like, I wasn't present with my family, my father, my grandparents. My grandparents was one, we lived with my father's mother. And I was not here. But I had one teacher that saw me in the inside. And to this day, she still is in my life. This lady would not leave my life. And if she had not been there, I don't know that you will be seeing me right now. She was my living angel.
Wow. I mean, Terry, you just said so many things that are impactful. You talk about you had a nervous condition. You were fearful. You talked about getting close with people because you were concerned that you weren't good enough, that they were going to leave you. Did this affect your relationships with other people, knowing that if you got too close, they may leave you because you didn't feel good enough? Did it affect your relationships with other people?
My friends, my father. My father was a known jazz musician, and he toured with Aretha Franklin a lot. So when he would leave, I would get in a real attitude and just have a tantrum. That's the word I'm looking for. I would have a tantrum because I'm like, you're not going to come back. You're not going to come back. You're saying that you're going to come back, but you're not. So I always had a very defensive way of anything that felt like somebody, if somebody is going to the store, I was having a tantrum that they was not coming back. It had gotten that bad.
Wow.
So it is a look. I need everybody to understand it is a look when you are trapped in fear. It's a look outside of yourself that others are witnessing. Something is off. You're here, inside here, and it's reality and it's real and it matters. But because it is so real and present to you, you have to get to somebody to help you untangle the unhealthy thoughts that are tormenting you, because they're tormenting you.
Wow.
And I had to do that.
Wow. So this, you talked about being afraid that if somebody went to the store, that they wouldn't come back. Your father going to play in this with this jazz band, you were convinced he wasn't coming back. Did this fear manifest in your behavior at school? Were you so fearful that you got in trouble at school? How did it affect anything at school, your behavior wise?
So I was more closed, like disappearing in class, and I got picked on a lot. I got picked on a lot. I had a lot of girls jealous of me because I guess I was the dancer, but to me, it wasn't being seen by the person I wanted to see it. So I still felt like I was disappearing, right? When I got picked on and beat up on, I didn't fight for myself because I felt like, what's the point of fighting for myself? I already don't feel like I'm important. So go ahead and fight. Go ahead and hit me. Push me down. I don't care.
So you allowed people to beat you up, Terry, because you didn't feel like you were worth it?
Say what they wanted to say, all of that. I could not fight. You are in total victim mindset. You have no strength in creating a sentence to tell yourself to stand up for yourself, that this is a wrong behavior. You don't have any sense of it. It didn't give me any sense of anything.
You were beat up. You were verbally abused. You were fearful that people that you got close to, when they left, they wouldn't come back. This all stemmed from the fact that your mother abandoned you, left you, moved, not out of the state, moved out of the country, went to Israel, and you never heard from her. This is traumatizing. It's very painful. And I know there's someone out there, Terry, that's experiencing the same feelings that you have felt. Please share with our audience some of the things that you did to help you through this and to cope with all of the pain and all of the fear that you were experiencing, what did you do? What are co some coping mechanisms?
So we had a counselor. Nobody used the counselors in middle school, but I did. I was there early, got in there, sat in the office. Sometimes I didn't want to go to class. I knew that my teacher, the one that I said was there for me, she told me I should go see him. And I trusted her, so I did it. But if I didn't go on my own, because I felt like, why am I advocating for myself when I don't feel like I even matter, right? So because she gave me that she mattered for me, she cared about me enough to tell me something to do, I went. And that became how I advocated for myself. I talked about my pain, and I never really talked about, we never even got to really how I really felt about my mother leaving, because I was just dealing with the anger. They took me in different parts of my mindset of the anger, the resentment, why I feel like I'm invisible. You know, they kept taking me in these feelings because that was the present surface. You know, people, when they go counseling, they're so overwhelmed by, I don't want to tell nobody my business. Why? You on Facebook, you know what I mean? You on Instagram. You need to tell somebody that is a technician, because they can help you untangle the unhealthy thoughts that you're digesting. You know, the Bible talks about out of the mouth.
Of babes.
You eat the foul fruit. You don't just eat foul fruit from foul words. You eat it from the words that don't bring you life. And that happens in your mind. So if the thoughts of those negative words are rotating in your mind, you're believing it. You're allowing your feelings to settle in it, and your body and being is displaying it. So I had to get help with that. And that was the longest journey, because coming out of the counseling, I'm like, my reality is still this. So how is it really helping? She's not still here. But what it does, consistently, what it does, it takes you in layer by layer, and it fills you up. And it gives you tools to replace what's broken. What's the broken information that you're feeding yourself? They're replacing it. The more you do that over and over and over, you start to get full as a person. You start to believe what you keep hearing versus the information that you're hearing. So I was going every day to counseling, every day.
You know, it is absolutely amazing that you're one of the few people that I've ever heard that actually embrace counseling and went to counseling. And what people don't understand is that counseling is there for a reason. It's meant to help you. There's a couple of things about counseling that I want to share, and you correct me if I'm wrong. When you go to counseling, if you go to a counselor and the counselor, you don't connect with the counselor and you don't like the counselor, you don't have to go back to that counselor. Find a counselor that you connect with. Because when you connect with the counselor, you build a relationship and it and stay there for the long term. This is not a one time, two time, three time session. It's going to take some time to get through and navigate through the pain and the fear and all of the emotions that you're experiencing. Would you agree that finding the right counselor makes a difference in your journey to healing?
So it's good that you say that. Counseling is a two-way of understanding, and this is what people need to understand. It is the actual office to untangle the negativeness, right? And you're repairing what's broken, right? You're really repairing you. You're not repairing the actual event that you're going about, right? People are not thinking that. They're actually thinking, like I was thinking going in, naive, what's the point? Because she's still not here. Well, the point is, no matter when life hits you, you've got to learn the responsibility of how to respond to it and not react to it. Because when you're reacting, you're taking away from the actual essence that God created you to be. And he can't flow blessings through you, and you can't see clear because your mind is
Right.
fogged and your lens is dark,
That's
which
right.
means your soul is dark.
That's correct.
So that's the purpose of going to counseling, because you can't change people and their decisions. You can only change your perception of how to deal with it and not allow you to disappear.
That is correct. That is correct. And the right counselor can help you navigate and get through this maze of pain and hurt. A good counselor can do that. It's very difficult for you to do it by yourself. It is very difficult. That's why we have counselors. And don't be afraid, like you said, don't be afraid to tell people what's going on. A lot of people say, "Oh, I'm not telling them my business," but they'll go on Facebook and tell people everything down to what they're eating for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. You're absolutely
And
correct.
that's not helping you. That's not helping you.
Nope, it's not.
It's not helping you. So why not advocate for
Absolutely.
the brokenness in secret with a person that can actually help you, give you the tools, versus nothing is in your basket because you're utilizing your natural strength instead of your spiritual wisdom from hearing the right tools to know how to aid yourself in every way we need it. We
Yes.
need the doctor. We need the mental. We need it all. Life is going to happen, and you got to understand how to respond to it. There's not a class
Uh-oh. Well, you know what, Terry? That's the importance of coping skills. You shared with us how you coped, and you even talked about dancing was part of your escape and the counselor. That is fantastic because the important thing is we don't want the cycle to continue. Your mom abandoned you. We have to break the cycle. We don't want it to happen because if you understand and you navigate through the pain, then you won't do the same thing with your children. So this is very important to understand how to cope and how to get through this. And you did a fantastic job. We certainly commend you and we applaud you because your courage in discussing the feelings of fear stemming from maternal abandonment, Terry, is commendable. You know, I'm going to ask you one more question.
Okay.
How did you navigate life while carrying this weight of such profound fear? How'd you get through life? I mean, you talked about fear and not trusting people and someone going to the store and you are like, "Oh God, they're not coming back. My mom left me, so they're gonna leave me too." How did you navigate through life and get to this point where you are in a better place? Just share that
I
with us.
gave my life to Jesus Christ at 23. I had my daughter at 22, and I gave my life to Christ. That's how I got through it. My grandmother, during the time my mother was leaving, would pray with me every night. And, I didn't understand at the time as a kid what getting on your knees and praying to a God you can't see would give me. But in the midnight hour, when you're consistent and when you continue to believe he can and he is, something every day gave me hope. Something every day allowed me to open up. Somebody was brought to me to speak positivity that was a female. I thought about all the mothers in my life that God put in my life, and it was over 25 that were mothers to give me each thing that I needed that I thought that I only could get from that one vessel. So I actually gained more because I surrendered myself to God's will, and He allowed it to fill me up. And now I am a mother of mothers, mothers coming up, women that have kids. Women that will become a mother because of your experience. So this is why you have to surrender to what is happening. Because if you don't just look at being a victim and don't stay sitting in the low place, it will feed you. And somebody will feed you.
Right.
Because somebody else is experiencing the same thing and it's past that same thing. So you have to trust. You can't hold your mouth closed. You cannot. Mouths don't get feed when they're closed.
Nope.
You have to advocate for yourself. You have to. In the brokenness, you have to give it voice.
Yes.
Because the
Yes.
moment that you give it a voice, here comes the food. Natural food and sometimes spiritual food. It'll lift off of you, and the next morning you don't even feel that and don't know why. That's how I made
Absolutely.
it.
Praise God and thank you so much. Wow, Terry, I want to thank you for your vulnerability, for sharing your story, for inspiring others out there. We know for sure that there's someone else out there that has been abandoned by their mother or abandoned by their father, and that's going through pain right now. And we are here to let them know that you will get through this. Seek help. Terry went for counseling. Terry did dancing. Terry had surrogate mothers. Terry had other mothers and other mentors and people that were in her life to fill that void. And we know it's never going to be the same, but do the best you can. Seek help because we know that it's a painful journey, but you can get through it. We are going to have Terry back next week as we continue our series on abandonment by a mother. Next week, we're going to address a critical aspect of healing, seeking help. So join us as our guest Terry shares her journey again towards finding support and recovery. Terry, thank you so much. We
Thank you.
appreciate your vulnerability and your insights and your story. We will see you next week.
See you next week.
Fantastic. Wow. We would like to thank Terry for her courage in sharing information on this sensitive topic. Wow. Thank you. Our hearts go out to you, Terry, and we appreciate you. We will see you next week. Now let's talk about habits to live longer and live better. We did this all last year, and we will continue to do it through 2024 because we are convinced and we have spoken to medical professionals, and they all agree. But the four things that we are recommending are things to help all of us live longer and live better. One, proper diet. Two, regular exercise. Keep moving. Don't stop moving. Don't stay in bed. Sit around all day. Don't do that. Reduce your stress. Meditation, watch a movie, anything to reduce your stress. Socialization is important. Be a part of a church, a group, anything. Just have that human action, interaction. Because it is important for our socialization and for our well-being. If you do these four things, you will have a positive impact on how you live. And we want you to live longer and live better. Remember, our focus this month, our topic this month is abandonment by a mother. We understand that this conversation can bring up a lot of complex emotions from our childhood and from things that we have seen, experiences that we've had. But we want to provide a safe space to recognize and understand them. So our goal is to offer comfort and strength through our conversations to those who can relate. We're lucky to have so many amazing resources and community organizations available, such as Terry's outreach group that offers support and understanding. And as a society, we sympathize. It's our moral and ethical responsibility to protect our children and provide support to families in need. So they can create a stable and loving home for all children. For children or teens facing mental health challenges, it is important to reach out to trusted adults like your parents, school counselors, or healthcare provider. I encourage anyone experiencing mental disorder or illness to reach out to nimh.nih.gov for additional support, or they can simply call 988 to get support, to get help, or just to talk. Stay strong and reach out if you need it. Thank you so much for joining our show. We encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel at DG Incorporated and watch our show every Friday evening at 8 p.m. Thank you so much for joining us. We will see you next week. Voila.
I'm Kevin Harrington, an original shark from Shark Tank. DG Incorporated provides coaching services to help entrepreneurs open and grow assisted living facilities and build economic wealth. Visit their website to learn more.